Indeed, love has a name, and the name is Jesus. The time is 6 minutes after the hour of 9 o'clock here in Agape FM. It is the 29th of September 2021, and it all depends with where you're listening from. Let me say good morning once again, good afternoon, and good evening. My name still remains AK. On Wednesdays, you know what we do from 9 to 10 is the Covenent Success with Pastor Mark Sunny. Last week he wasn't here and I've missed him so much. I hope you miss him too. And of course, every time he comes through, we get to talk about the things that we should do, the things that we focus on when it comes to making it in this life. We'll be looking at the Bible. Every time we have a session in the studio, we have someone we are interviewing, we stream it live on our Facebook page. That's the Agape FM. You can get to share, like our page. Make sure that you tell your friend to tell your friend that there is a Agape FM. We are more than a radio station. This is a place where destinies are being changed, a place where the lamb will walk and broken hearts are going to be mended. Without wasting much of your time, how are you doing, sir?
I'm blessed. Good to hear from you again. It's been a long time.
Yeah, it has been long. Last week I was alone on a Wednesday and people were not getting used to having you, but sometimes we'll be facing things that we cannot avoid. So talk to us, say, what do you have for us in store today?
Hallelujah. Good morning, listeners. It is a blessed day. It's a beautiful day. I still believe that God is still on the throne. God is still walking his miraculous work on his people. I believe that it is time for the people of God to succeed. I believe it is a time, the church that God or Christ is coming for is not going to be a poor, weak church. It's going to be a beautiful, beautiful, successful, powerful church. And believe in this season, God is glorifying himself in the life of every Christian, every believer, true believer. In the name of Jesus, I believe after this morning that God will glorify himself in your life. Hallelujah.
Amen. Oh, that's so amazing. You know, sometimes in life we'll be facing through challenge, we'll be facing challenges and we need to be encouraged from time to time. You know, that's why every time I meet you, I get so excited to get to talk about the Word. Well, it's not every day you get to talk about the Word of God. When you're at home, you're watching the news, they're talking about how many people have died. Yesterday I was looking at how these three young women were murdered, and I'm thinking at the back of my mind, this might be actually ministering fear to some young women out there. Mm. And every opportunity that we get to discuss and to talk about the Word of God, I personally do not take it for granted. But faith comes and comes by hearing the Word of God.
Hallelujah.
For us to change our minds, it means that we should actually invest in something. And right now we're investing in the Word of God. What do you have for us?
Hallelujah. I believe also that the last day weapon for our success, the last day weapon for our victory, the last day weapon for our victorious life, a successful life, is information, knowledge. Mm-hmm. Knowledge of the Word of God. Mm-hmm. Focus on the Word of God and make sure that you know the Word. Even you know the Word, even though the Word is around you is falling apart, your own will always have stability. So I believe God's Bible says, he said, my people perish because of lack of knowledge, not because the devil is strong, not because the devil is become mightier than God, but because my people are lacking knowledge. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And that is why we are. I jump on this offer of coming to speak the Word of God. Nothing else. Nothing will save you these days except the Word of God. Good philosophy, good knowledge, good wisdom, it doesn't amount to the Word of God. True understanding of the Word of God gives you power and gives you understanding. Hallelujah.
Amen.
This morning, I just want to speak on what I call, I've been thinking of what to call it, but I call it walking in success, in success. And I just want to start this morning by, let us read the Word of God in the book of 3 and 4. And we can take up something from there as we kick up this morning.
Is that John?
Yes.
3 John verse 2.
3 and 4.
Verse 3 and 4.
Yes.
For I rejoiced greatly when the brethren came and...
Read 2 first.
2 first, sorry. Mm. Beloved, I wish above all things that thou may prosper and be healthy, even as thy soul prospereth.
That is the wish of God. That is God's own mind towards his people, that people must prosper. Prosperity means things go well for them. That things must go well for you. That is my wish. That is my thinking. That is what my heart is full of. I'm thinking that you should prosper and be in good health, even as your soul prospereth. So any devil or anything telling you that God don't wish you well, that thing is a liar. Anything that is telling you that God wants you to die young, that thing is from the devil. The only thing that tells you that God doesn't want you to prosper and be in good health and prosper in your mind, that thing is lying. God wish us to succeed. God wants us to make it in this life. Hallelujah. Verse 3.
Verse 3. For I rejoiced greatly when the brethren came and testified of the truth that is in thee, even as thou walkest in the truth.
Hallelujah.
I have no greater joy than to hear that my children walk in truth.
Hallelujah. Inasmuch as God wants us to succeed, inasmuch as God wants us, it's a choice that we have to make to walk on that truth to succeed. That is why verse 3 and verse 4 says, he said, I have no greater joy than that to see that my people are walking in truth. If you decide not to walk, or you decide to walk against the truth, they cannot succeed. You cannot prosper, even though God wish you to prosper. If you decide to walk contrary to the truth, walk outside the truth, you can never succeed or prosper, even as God have wants you to prosper. You have to walk in truth. You have to be faithful to the truth. You have to be faithful and committed in walking in the truth. And if you can't walk on the truth, there is, even though it's a wish of God, even though it's God's mind, even though you're trying, you're crying for God to bless you or God to make you succeed, because you're not walking in the truth, you cannot succeed. You cannot prosper. The truth matters a lot. Hallelujah.
Wow. I just thought of a clue. The truth shall set you free. Sometimes there's certain things that won't happen in our life just because we do not know the truth. You know, before you came, say, I was just talking about something in the first hour about how Peter writes related to the in the book of Ephesians, from, I think, from chapter 1 to chapter 3, talk about how God has blessed us. It is all in the past tense. So for someone to really know that this is what God has given me, the person, they have to search the truth. Yes. When they know the truth, now they get to a point where they say, you know what? This is what God has done for
me.
And people don't really get to study and to try to know what God says about them.
The truth. According to... look, we are living in a world of misinformation. We are living in a world of disinformation. We are living in a world of lies. The devil keep on pumping lies. Anytime he has opportunity to tell you lies, he tell you lies. Tell you lies, church is wrong. He tell you lies, pastors are thieves. He tell you lies, all different types of lies. All gearing up to make God look like he's no more God. But he cannot stop God. He can only stop the believer who believe on those lies.
Amen.
The truth is this. A truth, Bible says in the book of John chapter 14, verse 6, he say, I am the way, the truth, and the life.
Amen.
The way I understand that scripture is that Jesus is the way that leads to a truth that will give you a life, a successful life.
Wow.
Is a way that leads you to a truth that will lead. Truth is Jesus came to be the truth. From Genesis to Malachi, devil was speaking and telling people there was nothing like God. Although God tried the Magician, tried to use the prophet to prophesy that there will be a day the truth will be revealed. And that the truth that is coming is Jesus. to show the world that God is with us. Emmanuel is coming. Hallelujah.
Well, our dear listeners, you heard what Pastor saying. Don't forget, you can comment on our Facebook page. You're streaming live. Then Peter Ordinary said, it's good to see you, Pastor Mike, and you're saying the truth. It's good to know that you're also tuned in. So, Pastor, tell us more. Tell us more. You said something interesting about Jesus. That one, I think you should repeat the statement as well.
Jesus is really so way. Is a way that leads to a truth that will give you a good life.
Amen.
That will give you, if you omit the way and omit the truth, there's no life, no successful life, no prosperous life, no good life. As long as you keep the way, you follow the way, and it will lead you to a truth being Jesus. Hallelujah. And when Jesus is revealed, you are walking in truth. That Jesus, you're walking in Jesus. That means the life, successful life of God will begin to be revealed in your life. You cannot jump steps. A lot of us want to live that life without the truth. You want to live that life without walking on the way. You want to have a successful life without walking in the truth, which is impossible. You must walk in the truth for you to not walk against the truth, not walk contrary to the truth, but walk in the truth for you to come to the life, that successful life and prosperous life that God wants for you.
And the Hallelujah. Truth is Jesus.
Jesus Christ.
Wow.
Hallelujah.
So see, this is something, you know, seems as if I'm hearing this for the first time ever since I was a Christian. So the truth is Jesus.
Jesus is the truth.
For us, we should actually live in the truth.
That's the truth. Wow. That's the truth. Jesus is the truth. You walking in him or being in him is only truth.
Wow.
Every other thing is a lie. Every other thing. That is why he said, no one coming to my Father except through me. That is the only truth. The truth, when he came to the earth, he came to confirm the truth about God. He came to make the truth about God known to the world. He came to, before from Malachi to Matthew, it was they call it a dark age in the church. It looks like there's no more God. But when Jesus was born, the Bible says he was called Emmanuel. And Emmanuel means God is with us. God has not left us. God is still with us. And that confirmed the truth that the prophets have been prophesying before now. Hallelujah. And I believe that immediately we begin to walk in the truth, the life of God begin to be revealed. The life of the kingdom, the true life of the kingdom begin to be revealed in our lives. Hallelujah.
Now, speaking of Jesus, sometimes we have testimony. We hear testimonies of people. You know, you mean that, you know, there's people that will acquire riches. They will have all the money and all the properties in the world. But at some point, they get to a point in their lives when they say that, they feel like they feel empty. They go to places searching for that thing. Then they tell you that I met Jesus. Then you also have on the extreme side, someone is poor, someone has nothing, they're struggling in life, and they've tried everything possible. And when they meet Jesus, things will start to happen.
Hallelujah. And that is why I'm smiling is that I'm starting to look. The issue about Jesus is the truth. One thing from what you're saying, there's no true riches except the one that comes from Jesus.
Amen.
True wealth, true riches, true power. You can. There's many ways to route power. You can go to Sangoma and get power. You can use any diabolical means to get riches. You can use rituals and get riches. Devil give riches. But the true riches that will last, that will endure, the true riches, the true wealth, the true blessings, the true goodness of God is only from Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Anywhere you go through it, anywhere you go to get it, except through Jesus Christ, it will not give you fulfillment. It will not give you, it will not last. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So that is the truth about the word of God. That is the truth about Jesus Christ. Hallelujah.
Wow, that's so profound. That's so nice. So, you know, I've just realized as people, we don't want to study scriptures. And it seems as if it's so difficult for someone, even for people, someone like me. I got born again when I was 15 years of age. And it's over 15 years. And imagine each and every, sometimes I struggle to study scriptures. So I was thinking, when we talk about Jesus being the truth, us, you know, one having to study the word, I'm going to divert a little bit.
Mm.
Someone was asking me one day, saying that, Is it the devil who is making me not want to study scriptures? Or it's me who has not created that habit yet? I've not come to that point where my system, my spirit know that this time I'm supposed to study scriptures. Well, what can one do to improve their word life so that they come to the full knowledge of who Jesus is?
It still comes down to the first thing we said before we started,
mm-hmm.
which is, my people perish because of lack of knowledge.
Mm.
If you know that studying your scripture, or whenever you study or sit with your scripture, you're sitting with the truth.
Mm.
You're sitting with God. You're sitting with the word. You're sitting with the spirit of God.
Mm.
There's no other way that God can speak to you through his word. If you realize that, know this, it gives you access into, or give you the power, or whenever you pick it up, you know that anything that will make you not to pick it up is denying you from being with God, denying you from being knowing the truth, will deny you from walking in the truth. Anything that hinders you from it, it is about coming to a point where you understand, you know that this word is not, I'm not just reading newspaper.
Mm.
I'm not just reading novel. You understand? I'm reading the word of God. And that is what brings me closer to him. That is what makes me build more Jesus in me.
Mm.
And we should know, I was telling them some time ago, I said, there are two things that makes us get something from God.
Mm-hmm.
Two things. One is that we have to be particular of what we want.
Wow.
Anytime Jesus comes to somebody to heal him, to, it doesn't matter how sick you are. It doesn't matter. He will ask you, what do you want?
Wow.
He will always ask that question to you. What do you want me to do for you? It doesn't matter. He see what you're doing. Because assumption is the lowest form of knowledge.
Mm.
So, the first of all, you have to be particular. Two is that you have to focus.
Mm.
Until you focus on the word of God, what you focus on is what you look like.
Wow.
Until you focus and know that you understand the benefits that is in it, and you won't allow devil to cheat you out of it. Hallelujah.
Wow. You know, the book of Corinthians talks about beholding ourselves in the mirror. So the more we look, the more we become.
Definitely.
And unfortunately, a lot of people, every time, you know, sometimes you'll be having friends and people that say, God bless me, God bless me. But people are not very specific. And I'm thinking, even in the Bible, Jesus would ask, what do you want? Yet Jesus can say that this person is blind. But Jesus is saying, what do you want?
And
I've realized one thing. I was listening to Dr. Miles Monroe. talks about, in life, people don't know what they want. One of the questions that should be able to answer is, what do you want? What is your purpose? What do you stand for? And a lot of people, they're just living, and now they just take one day as it comes. They don't know what they want.
That's
a very important question.
If you sit them down, ask them, what do you want? They can't even, in one sentence, tell you what they want in life. Mm. So it's always difficult. There are three things I find out. Either can hinder you from walking in the truth or walk against the truth.
Mm.
Number one is in the book of Luke chapter 2, verse 42. Can we read it a little bit? It's just going to be a little story about how Jesus.
Luke chapter 2, verse 42.
Yes.
Chapter 2, verse 42. It reads, And when he was 12 years old, they went up to Jerusalem after the custom of the feast. And when they had fulfilled the days, and they returned, the child Jesus tarried behind in Jerusalem, And Joseph and his mother knew not of it. But they, supposing him to have been in the company, went a day's journey, and they sought him among their kinsfolk and acquaintance. And when they found him not, they turned back again to Jerusalem, seeking him. Hallelujah. And it came to pass that after 3 days, they found him in the temple, sitting in the midst of the doctors, both hearing them and asking them questions.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. I just want to use something there, a pick up there. Mm-hmm. Look, until you walk with Jesus,
mm-hmm.
you're not walking in truth, and mm-hmm. you're not going to succeed.
Mm-hmm.
It's just going to take time. A lot of people are just taking, life is taking time to get to where they want to get to.
Mm-hmm.
The Bible said, in this place we read, Bible said, it said they left thinking that Jesus is with them.
Mm-hmm.
They left thinking that Jesus is among them.
Mm.
I said the lowest form of knowledge is assumption.
Mm.
Are you with Jesus? Mm. Are you with, if you, can you surely say that Jesus is with you?
Mm.
Are you surely, can you usually say in that your business, in that thing you're doing, in that your office, or what you, can you surely say that Jesus is with you?
Mm.
Or will you be, after some times, you look back, you find out that Jesus is not there.
Mm.
So they wait, the Bible said they left, they have gone a day journey.
Mm.
Why they have gone a day journey? They look now, they start looking for Jesus. They start turning around looking for him. And they took another 3 days to go find him.
Mm.
So if you don't walk in truth or walk with the truth,
mm.
life will delay you.
Wow.
If you don't walk in the truth or walk with the truth, brother, things that would have happened, your journey to success will be delayed in life.
Mm.
That is one way that you ought to, every time you ought to ask yourself, is Jesus with me? As long as he's with me, as somebody said, when your boat is sinking, don't check whether your boat is strong enough to carry the storm. Or to be or to ride the storm, you have to check whether Jesus is in the boat.
Mm.
Don't check whether the boat is strong, but check whether Jesus is in the boat. As long as he's there, you're not sinking. You're not going down. As long as Jesus is there. Hallelujah.
As long as Jesus is there, there is no delay.
There's no delay.
And you know, even his mother, Mary, they literally assume that Jesus is there. Assumption is the lowest level
of knowledge.
Form of living. And sometimes in life, we just want to go without Jesus. But sooner or later, we'll tend to look for Jesus. And it will take us time to get to a destination.
To get to the destination. I was illustrating it some time ago in church. I said, sometimes you might stand up with two people can stand up now. They are going to Green Acres, for example.
Mm.
And on their way to... God is leading one. God is not leading one.
Mm.
One is going on his own.
Mm.
And God will, how he does his things, he can lead you not to Green Acres first.
Mm.
He lead you to Summer Strand first.
Mm-hmm.
And you will be worried and be asking, oh, why is he leading? There's no route from Summer Strand to Green Acres.
Mm.
So why is he doing that? But God knows what he's doing.
Mm.
As long as you're with him, because if you leave him, one day you will, when you get there, the person that left before you, when he get there, he has to wait until you come.
Wow.
Because God is leading. He knows tomorrow more than you.
Oh.
So you shouldn't assume that God is with you. Rather, you should always be sure that he is with you. Wow. And as long as he's with you, success is guaranteed. Hallelujah.
Wow. That's so amazing. Say, then you say, okay. You said you have three things. Say.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Number two
mm-hmm.
is in the book of Luke chapter 10.
It's Luke chapter 10.
Mm.
Mm-hmm.
Luke chapter 10. Let's read verse 52. Is it up to 52?
No, it's 42.
Let's read 40.
Oh, verse 40.
Mm.
Luke chapter 10, verse 40. But Martha was cumbered about much saving and came to him and said, Lord,
look, please, can we go back again?
Verse 38.
Let me verse 25.
Oh, verse 25. Look for verse 25. Okay. He said, and behold, a certain lawyer stood up and tempted him, saying, Master, what shall I do to inherit eternal life? He said unto him, what is written in the law? How readest thou? And he answering said, thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, and with all thy soul, and with all thy strength, and with all thy mind, and thy neighbor as thyself. Hallelujah. And he said unto him, thou hast answered right, this do, and thou shalt live.
Praise the Lord. Continue.
But he, willing to justify himself, said unto Jesus.
Please, I can read from verse 30.
From verse 30.
Yes.
And Jesus answering said, a certain man went down from Jerusalem.
A certain man went down.
To Jerusalem.
He's going down. He's not going up.
From Jerusalem.
That is what I want you to. Bible is every word of God will have to be marked.
Mm.
He said, a certain man is going down to Jerusalem.
From Jerusalem to Jericho.
From Jerusalem to Jericho. Jericho. Others go to Jericho to Jerusalem. He's going to Jerusalem to Jericho. Jericho.
Mm-hmm.
Jerusalem is a place of worship. It's a place where things happen.
Mm-hmm.
But he's going away from Jerusalem.
Hey.
That is where problem always rise. You can't go away from the truth and doesn't face trouble in life. Bible said he was going from Jerusalem to Jericho. If you read the place, first place we are going, people were coming from Jerusalem. Jerusalem is a place where things, is a city where there is truth, there's God, there's seat, the tabernacle, there's an altar where people come to worship. But he himself was going down and going away from it. Wow. So the truth, Bible said, he fell among thieves. The enemy will steal from you anytime you stay away from the truth.
Wow.
The enemy will steal life. He will leave you useless anytime you stay away from the truth. You don't need to go down in life. You need to go up in life. And the only way up is to walk in the truth. Continues.
Okay. A certain man went down from Jerusalem to Jericho and fell among thieves, who stripped him of his raiment and wounded him and departed, leaving him half dead.
That is what the devil would do to any man that doesn't walk in truth. That is the key. That is the work of the devil in any man that doesn't believe in walking in the truth or walking away from the truth. Why the devil is attacking, afflicting, and killing and destroying is the truth. When you stand in the truth, which is Jesus, as we emphasize, you don't walk away from Jesus, you will see that you will definitely overcome the devil. Praise the Lord.
You know, sir, I was just thinking, you know, we say something interesting, that Jerusalem is a place of worship where things are happening. And we have realized certain people that are in church right now, and they feel like nothing's happened in their lives. You know, they're being taught the word. They want things to happen fast, quickly. And they're saying, look, I've been here in Jerusalem. I've been in church. I've been with Jesus and God. Now let me go out and try certain things. You find people that go out. Maybe after 2 years, they come back. They have lost
everything. They lose their color. They lose their color. They lose their life. You see that the person is in a sorry state. Because why? You cannot walk away from the truth. You cannot walk away. I said, church is the last hope of this generation. Whether we like it or not, church is the last hope of this generation.
Amen.
There is no other place. Where we get our daily hope is in church.
Amen.
There's no doubt there are many churches that you don't even know whether it's churches. But if you have the Spirit of God, you will know the true one, that's Jesus in it.
Amen.
This man walked away from Jerusalem and things go wrong for him. The thieves attacked him. The enemy attacked him, even left him for dead. Don't allow things, don't walk away from church. Don't walk away from Jesus. Don't walk away from the things of God so that the enemy doesn't attack you. If you want to succeed, walk with him. Don't walk away from him. Hallelujah. Amen. This is the second one.
Wow. And the third one say?
The third one is in John 20.
It's in
John 20, yes. Verse 25.
John 20, verse 25.
Yes.
It reads, the other disciples therefore said unto him,
Let's read this 24.
But Thomas, one of the 12, called Didymus, was not with him when Jesus came. The other disciples therefore said unto him, we have seen the Lord. But he said unto them, except I shall see in his hands the print of the nails, and put my finger into the print of the nails, and thrust my hand into his side, I will not believe.
Hallelujah. Continue.
And after 8 days again, his disciples were within, and Thomas with them. Then came Jesus, the doors being shut, and stood in the midst, and said, peace be unto you. Then said he to Thomas, reach hither thy finger, and behold my hands, and reach hither thy hand, and thrust into my side, and be not faithless, but believing. And Thomas answered and saying unto him, my Lord and my God. Jesus said unto him, Thomas, because thou hast seen me, thou hast believed. Blessed are they that have not seen and yet have believed.
Hallelujah.
And many other signs.
It's okay. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The story there is Thomas denying the truth. Because you don't see. In this kingdom, we don't see to believe. We believe before we see.
Amen.
So you don't, because of your situation, you don't believe that God is at work. God is always, when we believe the truth, God is at work. He will show himself strong in your life. Bible said that Jesus came and Thomas said, they told Thomas, Thomas wasn't there. Thomas said, I cannot believe until I see.
Wow.
I cannot believe the truth until I see it work. No, you don't believe. You believe healing before you receive healing.
Amen.
You believe in the things of God. You believe in success before you receive success. You believe in progress before you receive progress. You have to believe. You don't say, we don't believe. I must see first before I believe. And Thomas, because of that, Jesus came back and said, Thomas, okay, blessed are they that believe it, for they shall be a performance of which they believe in. Is what they believe that will be performed in your life. That is Luke chapter 1, verse 45. Blessed are they that believe it, for there shall be a performance of that which you believe. Until you believe that, you believe the truth cannot manifest in your life. The truth is meant to be believed. And when you believe the truth, Bible says the truth will show up in your life. Hallelujah.
So in this kingdom, we don't see to believe. We believe to see. Even the Bible is clear that without faith, it is impossible to please God.
Please God.
So we should have faith. We look at the things that are unseen. For the things that are seen are temporal. They are bound to change. But that thing that we do not see will last forever.
Forever. Hallelujah.
Wow.
Hallelujah. The truth, that is the truth we are talking about today. Walking in the truth. In success, walking in success, and the truth has a lot to do with it. Not to walk away from the truth, not to walk away from the truth, not to deny the truth, because the truth will always set you free, as you said. Amen. Hallelujah.
So say, you know, I know we are almost, you know, coming towards the end of the show, but I want, you said this before, but I would want you to say it again. What I've realized, a lot of people, when they hear success comments, they think of money, they think of riches, of cars and houses and everything. clothes in the kingdom, how can one best define the word success? What is success? What is true success?
Okay, from where we are reading, success is actually prosperity. Mm-hmm. And prosperity is, success is inside prosperity. Mm-hmm. And prosperity is actually things being well for you.
Amen.
Things being well for you financially, materially, spiritually.
Mm-hmm.
Being well for you. You, what others go through is not what you're going through. It is possible. Success means for you to succeed in the things of God. And not only succeed, look at, there are two things that devil fight in life.
Mm.
There are two things devil fight. He want to make you feel that God is a liar.
Mm.
Two is that he want to stop a Christian not to be glorified.
Mm.
He want to stop a Christian not God putting the glory in your life. And glory is what we call success.
Amen.
Is that all things work together for good for those that love the Lord and those who are called according to his purpose. If you grieve for that, he said, those he have called, he have justified. And those he have justified, he will also glorify.
Mm.
That glory, God called you first of all.
Mm.
And when he pick you up, he justify you. And when he justify you, he want to glorify your life. And that is the success we are talking about here. That things go well for you. If you read that place we read this morning, he said something. He said that you might prosper. If you read it from another, he said that things might go well for you.
Mm-hmm.
God's wish is that things go well for us. Success is bigger than money. It's bigger than that. There you can have money and your penny.
Mm.
And that is not prosperity that God wants for you. You can have things and still things are not the way things, your marriage is failing. That is not the success that God wants for you. Mm. You can have money, but your health is failing. Mm. That is not the success that God wants for you.
Mm.
He wants to all-round success. All around, everything is going well for you. Everything, when you look at it, it might not be in the pace of an unbeliever, but things are going well for you. Because I see unbeliever has money. Somebody said, if only thing you have in life is money, you are the most poor, you are the poorest human being on earth.
Mm.
Because life is bigger than money.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
You know, see, one thing I've realized is if you want to have a total life, a life of full, life of totality, you find it in God. Hallelujah. You know, sometimes you'll be reading around, you realize someone has millions, they're struggling to have a child. Some have millions, but they cannot even sleep in their bed.
Mm.
They're facing, the nightmares, they fear everything. Some of them, they have money, but you realize that they have cancer, terminal diseases.
Mm.
And if you want to have a life that is full of glory, that is a total life, it is only seen in God, in Jesus. And it is something that people don't want to talk about. People, they want to sugarcoat it, but it is the truth. That's why you find people after a long time of living, they give their life to Christ at 80. But imagine if someone is to give their life to Christ in their 20s,
early,
in their teens. Imagine living for 50 years, a life of glory, a life that's full of, amazing things in life and God.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Thank you very much, Say, for today. It was quite so profound,
mm-hmm,
and amazing. And, some of the scriptures that we read from time to time,
uh-huh,
and we're thinking, and it needs a man of God like you to reveal certain things to us. And one thing that I've realized is, in as much as God has blessed us, as much as God is going to bless us from time to time, God blesses us through men of God.
Amen.
And you're a blessing to us, and I thank you very much.
Amen.
And I know, sometimes people don't really leave comments here, but if you go on the Facebook page, you see the views, you see, oh, people, have been watching, and sometimes you hear someone saying, who is that man of God that you're talking to?
Mm-hmm.
That is with you, and thank you very much. I said, thank you, mate. Thank you very much for making time to be with us here at FM and so that the name of the Lord will be glorified.
Hallelujah.
Naaman was telling him that if only it's possible, I could have you every day of my trip, so that you get to learn more from time to
praise
time.
Praise the Lord.
But say before I let you go, can you please leave us with a word of prayer?
Hallelujah. Father, we thank you this hour. Thank you for what you have done through your word. Thank you for the light of your word that is shining upon every listener in the name of Jesus. Father, we begin to decree right now that the wicked power, that power that want to make your word of no effect, that is working in this generation, let it be arrested in the name of Jesus. Every antichrist spirit, let it be rebuked and be destroyed in the name of Jesus. We release the spirit and the power of God, the glory of God upon the life of every listener right now. Let it begin to suffocate and destroy every ordinary, everything that comes from their natural life to stop their life of God in the name of Jesus. I release the Zoe part of God among every listener in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father, because even as they go out now, the Spirit of God is at work. The power of God is at work, making a way where there is no way. Touching lives right now in the mighty name of Jesus. I cover everyone that is under the sound of my voice with the blood of Jesus. I cover their life with the blood of Jesus. Before we come back next week, I decree there shall be testimony and your name shall be glorified. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Thank you very much, Pastor. You know, something just came to my spirit. You know, sometimes certain people, they get born again after hearing, you know, a certain man of God praying. And there's certain people that will never give their life to Christ unless they hear me preaching or unless they hear you. Mm-hmm. So to our listeners, tell them where your church is. Because maybe someone is saying, I want to go and hear that man on this side.
Hallelujah. Yeah, we are in Ring Street, in Port Elizabeth here. And Ring Street, number 16 Ring Street, upstairs. We are there every Sunday, every Wednesday, and every Friday. Friday is our prophetic, we call it Hour of Change. It's a prophetic prayers. And on Wednesday, is our, like today, by 6 o'clock, we have our breakthrough service, where we break into the Word of God and read the Word of God. No, life is about nugget. Life is a secret. Mm-hmm. And until you know the secret of the Word of God, that will certain strengthen you and make you a success out there. So we, on Wednesdays, we do that. And on Sundays, we do our celebration service, which starts from 10 o'clock in the morning, Sunday morning, finish by 12:30 or quarter to one. And I sometimes have my counseling sessions on Tuesdays from 11 o'clock to 4 o'clock. Every Tuesday I have my counseling session, which you make contact with us through our make appointment. We go into deliverance prayers, into deliverance sections, healing sections, and that's the rest. And God has been glorifying himself.
So if you don't mind sharing the number where people can contact you, because maybe someone out there really want to get in contact, if there's an office number where someone can contact you.
You can call us in, at the meantime, 073-026-4744. At the meantime, just to, before the office is set together, we are still working on one or two things to set the office together. So you can get me on this number, 073-026-4744. I will be glad to see you, because I know that in this age, God is doing great things. No matter what is the situation, come, let's pray about it. We are a church that believe in the word and believe in prayer, and God will do it for you. God bless.
Thank you very much, say. You know, for dear listeners, sometimes, you know, when someone is speaking, maybe you want to go to his church and get to hear him more. And you say the number 073-026-4744. Pastor Mark Sunny. Thank you very much, say, and I'm really blessed.
I appreciate it. Thank you very much. Thank you, TK.
Dear listeners of Akapa FM, thank you very much for choosing us as the station of your choice. And one thing is certain, that your life will never be the same again. Here's a song from Janet Manya featuring Number, Mubekan, but with a song, you are more.